So there is a traditional way to do this question, correct? And one more way is what? The shortcut method. If the volume of the parallel pipe formed by three non-Copeland vectors A, B, and C is 4 cubic units, correct? So in the question, what they are given? They are asked as what? A cross B, then B cross C, and C cross A. Correct. So, what is the property of scalar triplet product? So, by using scalar triplet product, what is it basically? This is equal to ABC the whole square. In the sense, ABC value is given in the question. What is it? ABC value is what in the question? It is given as 4. So basically, it is 4 square. So answer is 16. ABC is given in the question in this. That is 4 cubic units. Correct? So this is equal to basically what? ABC the whole square. In the sense, 4 square. 16. So my correct answer is option number 2. Okay, so kindly note down this. Yeah, so I'm going to the next question now. Question number 50. Please do this and tell me the answer. Question number 50. Yeah, so I think question, this should be plus. Okay, I think there is a printing error. This is alpha A plus beta B plus gamma C. Yes, this question, there's a printing error in this. How many of you did not understand this question? Did not understand. So I think I'm getting different options in this. Okay, I think Rhea has sent me, told me one option. I'm getting another chat. Option B. Okay. Could you please share me the working? Because four students has told me four different answers, all the options. Fine, let me anyway do this question. Okay. See, so basically in the question, they given the points, correct? So what is my A vector first thing? I plus 2j plus 3k, correct? And my B vector is what? 2i minus j plus k, correct? And then my c vector is what? 3i plus 2j plus k. So in the question they given us what? A cross, then I'm not writing the vector symbol here, kindly ignore me for the same. This is equal to what? B dot a dot c minus c bracket a dot b. So make sure that all the vector signs are there. Since the entrance program, that's the reason I'm not writing any of these things. Correct? Yes, and what is my A? Vector A. Vector A is what? In the question, I plus 2j plus 3k, B is this thing. Correct? So now, first I'll substitute what B vector I will substitute here. B is what 2i minus j plus k, correct? And what is my a dot c value? I think everyone knows the multiplication. 1 into 3, 3, correct? 2 into 2, 4. 3 into 1, 3. Yes? So what is it basically? 3 plus 4 plus 3. I think everyone knows the multiplication here. 3 plus 4 plus 3. And minus c vector. What is my c vector here? 3i plus 2j plus k. And again, I'm doing a dot b. So again, I'm getting is what? 2 minus 2 plus 3. Correct? Yes. And now what is my 3 plus 4 plus 3? It is 10. This value is equal to 10. So now I have to multiply this inside this bracket. As similarly, this value 3 I have to multiply inside this bracket. Correct? So once I'm doing this, what I'll be getting? 20i minus 10j plus 10k minus 3 into 3, 9. Correct? Minus 9i plus 6j plus 3k. And once I'm simplifying this, 20 minus 9 is what? 11i. 11i minus 16j plus 7k. Up to this, everyone is clear? Up to this step? Up to this step. Yeah, fine. Now, coming back to the question. They given what? Alpha A plus beta B plus gamma C. Correct? That is in the question they given. Let me take the question here. The question is what here? Alpha A plus beta B plus gamma C. This is A cross B cross C. Yes, and one more way, the best way of doing this is comparing the coefficient also, we can do it. See, what is the comparing the coefficient thing? See, comparing the coefficient in the sense, I think Pradeep has told me in the chat. Yeah, one is this is a longer method, correct? So this I just did so that everyone knows this is the way to do it, if someone has forgotten the way. One more method of doing this is what? Comparing the thing. A cross B cross C is equal to what? Alpha A plus beta B plus gamma C. This basically A dots, that is nothing but I can write this what? A dot C dot B vector, correct? Minus A dot B dot C vector is equal to alpha A plus beta B plus gamma C. Now I have to compare what? The like coefficient, I have to just compare. Correct? And just compare the like coefficient. So that is also one more way of doing the thing here. So alpha A, what is my A, alpha A value here? What is my alpha value? A vector is this thing, B vector is this thing, C vector is this. This is my B vector, this is my C vector. What is my alpha value? Alpha value, if I compare, alpha value is what? Zero. Correct. What is my beta value? Beta value is what? A dot C. A dot C, what is the value I got here? And let me take the thing. Let me take the screen. Previously, I think I had done it. What is the beta value I'm getting? What is the A dot C value I'm getting here? What is the A dot C value I'm getting? 10. Is it correct? Is it 10 or some other thing? So what I'm doing first I'm expanding all of these things, correct? If we want from this its step itself, we can do it. And what about the gamma value? Minus 3. How many of you did not understand this? Did not understand. Please feel free, open and tell me. Anyone who did not understand this? Okay. Okay, very good. I think Rohit has got the same answer. Is there anyone who did not understand this problem? Nikita? Let me check now. Yeah, I think Nikita has got the correct answer. I just now saw your thing. Rohit? Yes, 20. Okay. Let me check out. Admatesh got it. Yes. Fine. So just to explain, you see, I did not do any other thing. Basically, what I did is A cross B cross C is what? B vector dot A dot C minus C dot A dot B. A dot C value, I think everyone knows how to find. Correct? In the question they are given, see the question here carefully. They are given alpha A plus beta B plus gamma C. So I think in there is a printing mistake here. There is a reason they are given multiplication. Correct? So once we get this thing, alpha, it is nowhere in the picture. Correct? So alpha value is obviously zero. Correct? So this is a very easy question and can be done in 2 minutes if you just compare the coefficient. Okay, that's it. So then I think one of students told me about the perpendicular type question. Let me check it out. Yeah, 51st question. I think everyone got it. Okay, so 51st question. Yes. Correct. I think Subramaniam has given me the correct answer within no time. Let's see it. Yeah. 51st one. A plus B perpendicular to A plus MB. How many of you want me to do this? Is there any student who want me to do the 51st question now? Please feel free and be open. Because I got 3 correct answers till now. Yes, C. Yes, I think everyone has given me C as the option. Correct. Is there anyone who did not get C as the option? Is there anyone who did not get C as the option? Got C. So I don't think I need to do this, right? Let me just ask Vrishank. Vrishank, did you get it? Vrishank got it. Let me check on each and everyone. Let me check the chat. Then I'll come to know who has. Nitin has got it. 3. Atyesh correct. Rohit correct. Pradeep. Nikita. Yes, Sudeep, you are correct. Dot product value is 0. Nikita C, correct. Yes. Ria? No, I want to make sure that, is there anyone who did not get this thing? It's 3. Please feel free, open and tell me, okay? Got it, okay. Then I am not going to do and waste time. Then. This is just like that, you can tell me, 52nd question. So 52nd question reading itself will get the answer. A plus B plus C. Yes. I think everyone is getting option 2. Correct. B. Very quick. Is there anyone who did not get this thing? 2. I think everyone has got minus 3 by 2. Yeah. Okay. Next one, if A is a vector perpendicular to both B and C, then what is the thing? 53rd one. Fifty-third one, kindly check. If A is a work, if A is a vector perpendicular to both B and C, then what? It is perpendicular. A last option is not C. I think who has given me second thing? Nikita has done it. This is the last option. Last options to nowhere in the picture. We can just erase this thing off. Okay. So there is never ever gonna happen. The plus one. Those who got the answer, please send it to me on WhatsApp. Let me check. Please send to me, Rohit. You are very close, but not. It's A is a vector perpendicular. So, guys, this is a very simple thing. It's perpendicular to both B and C. 53rd one. I'll just do it for you. Okay. Since I'm not getting any answer in the WhatsApp, see, basically, this is nothing but I think everyone knows the cycle here, right? I, J, and K. And we all know what is the value. I cross I value is what? 0. So here, I'm getting A, B, and C. So A vector is what? I. B vector is what? J. And C vector is K here. Correct? So what is this basically? I cross J cross K. So this is basically what? What is J cross K? I cross I value is what? 0. Correct. So basically, this is the logic behind this. So what is the option in this? Option 2 is the answer. Yes, option 2 is the answer. 3 students have given me the correct one. So could you please let me know where you have done the mistake? Those who have tried, could you let me know so that I can help others also? That's the reason I'm just asking you, okay, please send it to me to my WhatsApp so that I can personally check and update this. I think, yes. Dot product, okay, A dot B cross C. Very close, that is actually 1 and 2. Yeah, so that is a common mistake that you will make. Yes, sine and cos values. Correct. Okay, Subramanian's option was, I thought dot product of two vectors is 0. Okay, fine. perpendicular dot product is here. Okay, Sudeep has given me. Fine, but kindly do not make these mistakes at the KCT examination, because after this you won't be using these formulas again in engineering. Question number 55. Yes, correct answer, Subramani. Yes, option B is the correct answer. I think everyone has given me option B as the answer. Yes, option 2. So I'm not doing the 54th question, because I think everyone knows the 54th question, right? Determinant of this thing we have to do, correct? Parallelogram. If it's a triangle, we have to put half. So I'm not going to do the 54th question. Anyway, this question, anyone having doubt, 55th one? 55th one, anyone did not get option number 2? 55th one. Got it. Everyone got greater than 3. Anyone want me to do this? Is there any student who want me to do the 55th question? Yes, the answer is greater than 1. Yes. Correct, because we'll be getting root 3 as the answer. Obviously, that is greater than 1. It cannot be less than 1, right? Yeah. 1.732. So, the formula is nothing but we do what A dot B. That is AB cos theta. Correct, and we'll do what? Cos pi by 3 value. Correct? Yes. Cos 60 value 1/2. Then a plus b the whole square is what? A square plus b square plus 2ab. We substitute all of these things and get the value. A dot b value. We'll get 3. 1, 1, and 3. Because they are two unit vectors. In the sense, a vector is equal to 1, b vector is equal to 1. Clear? I think root 3 you'll be getting 1.732, which is greater than. We'll get the answer as root 3. 1.732. is greater than 1. So option 2 is the answer. Let me check 56th one, not recording. 56th one.